Hi friends, we'll solve problem on kinetics of particles 3. Just see what is given in problem. Two smooth spheres A and B having masses of 2 kg and 4 kg respectively collide with initial velocities h1 in figure. If the coefficient of restitution for spheres is 0.8, determine the velocities of each sphere after collision and their directions. Masses of bodies A and B are given. They are 2 kg for block A and mass of body B is what? 4 kg. Now, this type of impact and first problem what you have solved, basic difference is what? In this problem, velocities of these bodies are non-collinear with line of impact. As these velocities are non-collinear, line of impact here is horizontal, LOI. Now, as velocities are non-collinear, type of impact is indirect or oblique impact. Therefore, components of velocities which are along the line of impact that will vary as per law of conservation of momentum and coefficient of restitution equation. And the components which are perpendicular to the line of impact remain same after impact. Therefore, first step is what? We'll resolve these velocities. Va is 2 meter per second. Therefore, if I'll resolve this velocity in the first horizontal direction, the horizontal component is what? Vax, and it is 2 cos of 30. That means Vax, 2 cos of 30, if you'll find out, comes out to be 1.732 meters per second. If we'll resolve it in vertical direction, direction of velocity upward, this component is vertical. Therefore, this component is written as what? Vay, and is equal to 2 sine of 30, sine 30 is half, therefore this component becomes what? 1 meters per second. As you are reading Vb inclined at 60 degree, if I will resolve, we will get one component in vertically upward direction. Say this component is what? Vby comes out to be what? 4 sine of 60. That means this, if we find out value, 3.46 meters per second. And horizontal component of this velocity will get leftward, and say this one is what? Vbx, which is equal to 4 cos of 60. 4 cos 60, cos 60 is half. That means this component will get what? 2 meters per second. Now, in our coefficient of restitution and law of conservation of momentum equation, we will get only horizontal component of velocities, where Vax rightward will substitute with positive sign. Vbx leftward will substitute with negative sign, and these components of velocities which are perpendicular to line of impact remains the same after impact. Therefore, if I'll represent this as a component after impact, say Va dash y, so this component remains same as 1 meter per second, and this component of this velocity in vertically upward direction Vb dash y, this will remain same as that of Vby, which is equal to 3.46 meters per second. That means you know vertical component of velocities after impact, but you have to find out only horizontal component. We'll apply first equation, law of conservation of momentum for these two bodies. Masses are known, velocities are known. Therefore, applying law of conservation of momentum, now equation will get in component form. Ma Vax plus Mb Vbx equal to Ma Va dash x plus Mb Vb dash x. Now, if you substitute your values of masses, mass of body A is 2 kg, that means Ma is 2, Vax rightward 1.732 plus mass of body B is given as 4 kg. Velocity Vbx is leftward, that is minus 2, equal to 2 times Va dash x plus 4 times Vb dash x. That means what equation you are getting, law of conservation of momentum, that is in terms of two unknowns, that components of velocities along x-axis. Therefore, here if we'll divide throughout by 2 and if we'll find out, VA dash X plus 2 times VB dash X, this value comes out to be minus 2.268. This is say equation number 1. Second equation will get as a coefficient of restitution equation. Coefficient of restitution equation, if you write, now that is in component form, E equal to minus of in numerator velocity of separation. That means what will get first one, second body means B, its horizontal component after impact means dash, minus VAX and again dash because velocity is after impact. Before impact, it is VBX minus VAX. Now E value is 0.8, which is equal to minus of VB dash X unknown minus VA dash X unknown divided by VBX is already known, but it is negative, therefore minus will substitute, and VAX is 1.732. Therefore, what will get here? VB dash X minus VA dash X, this value if we calculate, this one comes out to be 2.98, approximately 2.985, say equation number 2. Solving equation 1 and 2, you will get what both the components, say first component VA dash X equal to, this component what will get here, V dash X will get negative, minus 2.746, therefore 2.746 meters per second. I will add here direction, horizontal component negative answer you are getting, that means this direction is what leftward, and VB dash X equal to what will get here, 0.24 meters per second, but what answer you will get is positive, therefore we will write this one as right. But this, what we are getting here are components of velocities in horizontal direction. Components of velocities in vertical direction are as shown in figure, VA dash Y upward, VB dash Y upward, and horizontal components we have calculated. Now we'll represent both the components, and from that one we'll find out what is resultant velocity of these, you can say, bodies after impact. That means if I'll represent now, what are the velocity for body A? VAX, what you have calculated, body A, VA dash X is leftward, and its magnitude what you calculated, 2.746 meters per second. Vertical component of velocity, VA dash Y. From this one, resultant velocity for body A will get in this second quadrant, where this velocity will represent. Velocity is in second quadrant. Velocity is VA dash. Angle I'll write as say theta A. If you'll find out resultant velocity, that resultant velocity VA dash is square root of VA dash X square plus VA dash Y square. That means this V dash Y is what? This is 1 meter per second. That means 2.746 square plus 1 square, and if you take its root, this value comes out to be 2.923 meters per second, and angle theta A is tan inverse of V dash Y upon V dash X. This angle comes out to be 20 degrees. That means final answer for velocity of body A is 2.923 meters per second, and direction of velocity is what? 20 degrees. Similarly, for body B, if we'll represent, for body B, horizontal component of velocity is rightward, VB dash X. You have calculated this value, this one is 0.24 meters per second. Vertical component of velocity you have calculated, which one is what? VB dash Y, which is equal to, this one is 3.46 meters per second. From this one, if you will find out resultant velocity of this body B, which one is say VB dash and angle is what theta B, the magnitude of resultant velocity VB dash is equal to, if we'll calculate using calculator, which one comes out to be 3.468 meters per second, and angle theta B, tan inverse of VB dash Y upon VB dash X, angle comes out to be 86.03 degree. That means final answer is what? Velocities of bodies A and B just after impact. For body A, it is in second quadrant. For body B, it is in first quadrant. Thank you.